Yamaha actually surprised enthusiasts when it launched a delicious retro-looking yet tech-laden Yamaha XSR155 in Thailand back in August 2019. Words around the town is that it will soon launch it in India, and here is why we think it's perfect for our Indian conditions. The small capacity retro segment in the country is single-handedly dominated by Royal Enfields. Jawa entered the fray, but it couldn't make an impressionable dent in a category. What's currently lacking in this space is an old-school motorcycle tempered with Japanese technology and reliability. Hence, it would be bode well for Yamaha to exploit the segment with the launch of XSR155. Moreover, at present, there isn't a single 150cc liquid-cooled motorcycle that got the looks and is comfortable enough for everyday use. With the Yamaha XSR155, the Japanese brand would be able to conveniently hit two birds with a single stone. Since it's already based on already existing Yamaha R15 version 3, it would be even easier for Yamaha to manufacture it in India with part sharing. Sure, the brand could compromise on certain aspects and might replace the aluminium swing arm with a box section unit and the inverted forks with a traditional one, as it did with the Yamaha MT-15. Even then, it would make a compelling proposition, as these measures would only make it more affordable. Back in Thailand, the price difference between the fared R15 and the retro XSR155 is an equivalent of ₹14,000, with the latter being more affordable. Expect a similar delta for Indian market too, and with that in mind, the India spec Yamaha XSR155 could cost around ₹1,32,000 ex showroom. At this price, it would undercut the MT-15 by around 6,000 and go squarely against the Royal Enfield Bullet 350, priced at ₹1,39,000 ex showroom. Apart from being the only 150cc retro bike in India, it will also appeal to much wider set of audience than R15. Thanks to its easygoing ergonomics with wide, easy-to-reach handlebars and bench seats. Its classic looks are complemented by a properly modern liquid-cooled 155cc single-cylinder engine with variable valve actuation. This clever technology helps in maintaining a good balance between low-end grunt and top-end drive. The motor makes 19.3 PS and 14.7 Nm, linked to a 6-speed transmission with assist and slipper clutch. Other notable features include an LED headlamp and tail lamp, bulb indicators, and a fully digital instrument cluster. The India spec version could pack dual channel ABS as standard in a true retro scrambler fashion. The 17-inch alloy wheels are wrapped with 110 section front and 140 section rear tubeless block pattern tires. All in all, the Yamaha XSR155 seems to be promising enough to hog Royal Enfield's limelight in the small capacity retro segment. It's got the right set of features, a very likable design, and a performance-packed powertrain. What more could you possibly want? Just let us know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video next time.